This is a recording session. You ready?
Yeah, yeah.
What brings you here today?
You know, I need some help. I mean, I'm hoping you can answer some questions that I've been having.
Why don't you just start from the beginning?
Well, you know, it all started when I was this introverted cat that never knew what it was to be what it is. And, you know, I just saw the stars and it just, you know.
I'm here today talking with you as a friend, a psychologist, and because your wife and coworkers think you may have a serious problem. Why have you been absent from work and home so much? Well, Sigmund, if you really were my friend, you would know why. And the why is swinging flies for Steelhead. And why so much? My dreams, Sigmund, my dreams. What about your dreams? Do they haunt you? Yes, Sigmund. Yes, very much so. What are these dreams about? They're about my screaming fly reel and the steelhead that keep running and running. I can't stop them. I can't stop them.
The horror.
He's going back down the river. He's gone. Whew. That's it. It's gonna break.
Dreams like this can be very disturbing to one's health and well-being. Fortunate for you that I'm very knowledgeable and skilled in the diagnosis and treatment of my patients' dreams. Did these dreams start in your early childhood?
No, these dreams didn't start when I was a child. I didn't know what a steelhead was when I was a child.
I see. Do you suffer? Let me rephrase that. Do you have any dreams similar to the dream you just shared
but with a different outcome. Yes, I know it's complicated, but I have a dream where I almost catch a 20-plus pound steelhead. It's right on the bank. It's like I can almost touch it, and then it's gone.
And what significance does 20 pounds have?
To catch a 20-pound-plus steelhead, you become a member of the 20-pound club.
I see. And where does this club meet? And who are some of the members?
This club is in my head. There's no official club. It's just a club that I want to belong to.
I see, just as I thought. Delusion on a angler scale.
Monster steelhead.
When this steelhead rolled and jumped way down river, it looked like I had a seal on.
Again. That's a big run, buddy. Holy moly.
After 46 minutes, I finally get ready to beach this huge steelhead. I slowly walk back, trying to keep my line low and horizontal as to not hold the hook out. Sigmund, it's happening. The steelhead is on the beach in 6 inches of water. Help! The hook just broke. I see it swimming away. Help me!
Wow, that's an intense dream. Do these dreams affect you physically?
I wake up with blisters on my fingers.
Interesting. Do you have any other scenario-type dreams that bring stress into your life? This other dream affects me at least once or twice a year. But it's also real. It manifests in my life. It drives me nuts. And I lose self-confidence, sleep, and even food stops tasting good. I lose my mojo.
Your mojo? This is serious. What is going on in this dream?
I stop catching steelhead. I go from being on top of the world, catching fish after fish, and then suddenly, nothing, no thing.
What do you mean, nothing, no thing?
I can't catch a steelhead. I cast and cast and cast, thousands of casts, and nothing, no thing. It's like the river is empty. But I get reports of others catching steelhead. Everyone's catching steelhead. But all I do is cast and drive, cast and drive. Looks like the aesthetics of your dream are in sync with your mental, physical, and spiritual parts of your overall well-being. Oh yeah, I love the rivers. I love casting. I love hunting for steelhead. I also like a good grab to complete the adventure.
A good grab? What is that?
A grab, a pull, a strike from a steelhead. The tug is the drug.
I see. So this is like a runner's high, an endorphin rush.
I think it's more like the tug is the drug.
What I'm referring to by the term endorphin rush has been adopted in popular speech to refer to the feelings of exhilaration brought on by pain, danger, and other forms of stress, supposedly due to the influence of endorphins.
Then yes, I need a fix. I need a steelhead on the end of my line.
weighs about 8 pounds. Jumped a couple times. Mole with pink head with some pink flash, black. No, shooter would be perfect. Yeah. Well, that guy had been through there so many times, I'm amazed I picked him up. No, yeah, go ahead. Go up, you know, where I was. That's where I caught the other one, too.
When searching for steelhead, it's pretty much a guarantee you will find fellow fishermen. The hunt for hatchery and wild steelhead is a 365-day Zen adventure in the Pacific Northwest. The search for steelhead goes on. It's all about finding the steelhead.
See that jump? Yeah, it's on.
Thank you.
In deciphering your dreams, I can tell you're very passionate about this fly fishing affair with Steelhead. Also, as a certified psychologist in the state of Washington, I hereby diagnose you as an incurable metalhead. Wow, Doc, you got the terminology down. Metalhead? Steelheader? I do my best to observe and record the facts and jargon. Now back to your diagnosis. I find that you are abnormal to the point of addiction with your pursuit of fly fishing for steelhead. I do not find your behavior an endangerment to society, so I have no other recourse but to release you back into the river. Thanks, Doc.
in the forest where your father once lived. Through the leaves, down the hill, we were rabbits and all. And she said, and he said, there is no hunters here.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Dad?
I think he got off.
Oh, no. Woohoo!
That's a wild one for sure. Yeah. It's just gorgeous.